Amargosa Opera House and Hotel. Met a guy named Hank, who's a frequent visitor from Colorado, and he's now taking us to a remote ghost town depot mining camp thing. And we're now off the main road. This is where we should get away to survive or follow him. We're going to be adventurous and follow him. He's right in front of us over here in that red Toyota. He checked out, so we're good. So we'll see what we find.
We're standing on the bed of the Death Valley Railroad. It went from Death Valley Junction, which is down to our south, about 10 miles, to the Old Ryan Borax Mine, which is to the north and around the side of this mountain, about another 10 or 12 miles. The track was torn up during World War II, after the Ryan Mine was depleted and they needed the rails for other purposes. This is one of the problems that the engineers faced, spanning very flashy and very deep canyons that the railroad had to go over. They built this by hand. This was all hand work. There's a little railroad-like village a little ways from here, which we'll see in a little while. But this is one of the more dramatic problems that they had to solve.
So we're here with Hank, and we're at a new location just outside of Amargosa. So Hank, tell me a little bit about what this is. What is this?
We're standing in the spot where the railroad builders' camp was, where they lived while they were building the Death Valley Railroad. Now the Death Valley Railroad went from about 10 miles from here, Death Valley Junction, to the Ryan Mine, which is about 12 miles around here. These people lived in these small grave-sized stone structures that were covered with tarps, and then the supervisor's house and a supply house was the larger stone structure that's over there.
Let's pan over and take a look at the actual employees. So, and the last one's going to be the boss's house, what you're saying.
Right, yeah, and there was like several dozen of these little structures. And then there's the larger one.
Which is the boss.
This area actually remains virtually untouched to this day. It's actually quite unbelievable.